Yes, question A, this is out of 6 marks. So the examiner expects you to answer this question in a very, very different way from the rest of the questions. So very important. So question A, this question requires you to state your facts only. State your facts only, straight to the point, directly. Describe or simply mention without explaining or elaborating. And answer only in paragraph forms. Very important, in any history examination, ordinary higher level, answer in paragraph forms. Otherwise, if you do listing your points and all that, your maximum marks you can get is 3. This is from the examiner's report, therefore it is quite factual what I'm talking about. So again, let's try and what we are talking about in this above statement. So let's try with this question. What were Germany's main territorial losses at the Treaty of Versailles? What were Germany's main territorial losses at the Treaty of Versailles? So remember, we are only expected to mention in question A. Mention what were Germany's main territorial losses at the Treaty of Versailles. 6 marks. So 6 points, mention 6 points. Very important. Now there were territorial, these were the territories lost by Germany. Alsace-Lorraine was returned to France, then Danzig was made a free city under the League of Nations control, and Poland could use it as a port for its external trade. North Schleswig went to Denmark after a referendum, Rhineland was demilitarized, overseas colonies such as Namibia was given to South Africa as a mandate territory, Togo and Cameroon were given to Britain and to France, and the Sahel region was put under the League of Nations control for 15 years. Now remember, I also stated here that Ra is not accepted. So Ra and Sa are basically the same regions, but Sa was the region before World War took place, and that was the region that was being industrialized and where the mining was taking place, and this was the region that was given under the control of the League of Nations. And the Ra otherwise is the same place, but this was now in 1923 when we first see the introduction of this name in our history. The Ra, the place that was that was occupied by the French and Belgian troops because Germany could no longer pay the reparations. So, but however, you cannot say Ra was put into the League of Nations control for 15 years. It was back then, it was the Sa and not the Ra. So very important there. So you can see that I'm just simply mentioning Togo and Cameroon were given back, the colonies were given back. Denmark was given back after a referendum. North Schleswig went back to Denmark after a referendum. So basically you are just mentioning your points. Mention your points that answers the question. You just mention the territories that were taken away by the Treaty of Versailles. So very important thing. So your question two, very important. Now this is a question where most of our learners, if well mastered, this is one of the questions where we can scoop up a lot of points if we mastered it very well. So what are we expected then? So this question requires you to make a statement that answers the question. And the statement that answers the question, make a statement that answers the question, and then explain this statement by giving points. So give it support. So, and very important, do not give us a background on the event asked in the question, if that was not the question asked. So let's try and see an example here. Now explain why it was difficult to make a peace settlement which would please Britain, France and the USA. Now you see very clearly here, one can basically conclude that this question is taken from question 1 of section A, because it's talking about the Treaty of Versailles and the Big Three. So that's where you will expect these type of questions. Now very important question B, how do they expect us to answer? They expect us to mention, explain why it was difficult. So in this context, explain why it was difficult to make a peace settlement. Mention why it was difficult to make a peace settlement, and then you explain. Very important, you mention and then you explain. So we are mentioning why it was difficult to make a peace settlement between the Big Three countries. So why? They wanted to benefit. They wanted to benefit. That is what I mentioned. We get the point there. Now we explain. Wilson wanted everlasting peace, a fair treaty to all countries. Leo George did not want Germany to be harshly punished. On the other hand, Clemencia wanted revenge, Germany to pay reparations. And then another mentioning, they had different aims and different motives. So Wilson wanted an everlasting peace based on his 14 points. He did not want to provoke the Germans to seek for revenge. That is just Wilson's different aims and motives. Now, Lloyd George did not want Germany to be harshly punished. He supported the views of Wilson for Germany not to be harshly punished, as he wanted. Look at the motives of Wilson, as he wanted to convince, as he wanted to continue his trade relations with Germany, as Germany's recovery was essential to the European economy, and that a larger reparation payment would make this impossible. And Clemenceau, on the other hand, wanted the revenge, as most of the war took place on their soil and were attacked twice, which caused a huge damage and loss of lives. Clemenceau felt the treaty was not harsh enough as he wanted. So you see there very clearly, you can further mention their different aims and motives, and you will see that it is, you first have to mention, so you will see that you first have to mention a point and support your points. Very clearly you see there, you are giving the aims, you, so we are saying they had different aims and motives, correct? That's true. And then now you give us your details why you are saying so. So Wilson, his aims and motives, Clemenceau, his aims and motives, Lloyd George's aims and motives. So you see very clearly, you state, you make your statement that is answering the question, and then you explain this statement by giving supporting points. And then do not give us a background on the event. So this means basically, do not tell us how the peace settlement went. Because also giving us a background is simply, I will actually explain this as part of the slide that is storytelling. I will explain that down below there. So let's move on to answering question C. Question C is equivalent to 10 marks. It is a very, very challenging question. So far, the most challenging, if I am to say. So this can come in different forms, but the focus is the same. The learner is expected to answer from both sides, either agreeing or disagreeing with the statement made. And in the end, the learner is expected to draw up a valid conclusion. So which side, after you agreed and disagreed, which side are you then strongly supporting, so to say? Okay, so you must first respond to the answer. Very important, you must first respond to the answer. Candidates must constantly refer back to the question to ensure that they stay on the topic. Very important. Most of the time we don't always we only read the question once and we start deviating from the question. Therefore, it is important that you keep on going, referring back to the question to make sure that you are on par. And then a conclusion, especially in a C question, should not simply repeat information already stated. So you cannot just repeat what you have said in your agreement and your disagreement and call it a conclusion. Very wrong. And it will not score you points. So your type of responses can be, he was or not successful, the treaties were responsible or not responsible, it was fair or not fair, and many other types of responses can be given there. And then in a C question, candidates must refrain from telling a story without actually answering the question. I will also explain what is telling a story in my next slide, I believe. Now, as with all C questions, there must be a clear distinction. Very important, there must be a clear difference or distinction or contrast between points of agreement and disagreement. So, do not write your agreement and disagreement in the same paragraph, so to say. So, if this paragraph is about your agreement, the second paragraph, make it about your disagreement. Do not write your first sentence agreement, the second one disagreement. So, we must be very, very distinctive. So, and then do not use terms like to a large extent or to some extent. I agree to a certain extent, I agree to a large extent. No, try not to do that. Just simply say, rather agree or disagree, but support each side with a valid explanation. So, very important there. So, let's attempt then a question. So, let's try and attempt a C question then, my friends.